you getting a massage. That's so funny.
He's like the prettiest cat ever.
Yeah. Bengal tigers are really, really beautiful.
I saw this shirt at the Goodwill, and I immediately thought, this will definitely impress the Bunny Museum. Did my
scheme work? It's very impressive. Awesome. I saw it when you first came in.
$1.
Oh, you're kidding. Yeah. Oh, that's fantastic. $1. One bunny buck. Yeah. That's very cool.
What is it like to live in a living museum? So why do you love bunnies so much? What's your busiest visitor day? Is it Easter? Would you say that you're obsessed? What do your pet bunnies think about living in a bunny museum? What messages do you most want to convey to your visitors through the Bunny Museum? What's your favorite part about running the Bunny Museum? Do you have any advice for budding future living museum owners? Do you know that you have a local cult following? Where exactly does the Easter Bunny live? Does he live here? How can the average person, such as myself, bunnify their life? And is bunnification a path to enlightenment? So what challenges does the global bunny community face today? All right, so I'm done with my questions.
Excellent. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. A beautiful bunny. Is it wearing a crown?
No, it's Van Gogh bunny.
Oh, I can't believe you said that. That's incredible. That's so funny.
Yeah, he took his ear off.
That's so funny. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. That is hysterical. Is he holding it?
Yeah.
Oh.
No, he's like.
Has to have an Easter egg or have it looks like an Easter bunny. Not just any bunny gets in there.
Scary bunnies?
Have what?
Scary bunnies?
No. Like no, we don't have a category that's scary.
Did you ever see Donnie Darko?
Yes, we have. It's in the film section. Yeah.
Oh, there's a film section?
Yeah. Yeah.
What's a group of bunnies called?
You mean a litter?
I see.
Thank you.
That one's pretty scary.
Which one?
That one.
Yeah, that's our Halloween one.
And then there's a bright red one in
Bad
the
bunny.
Corner of the room. Oh, let's go in here.
So your grandparents were in a library and saw books like that?
Both my grandfathers, one in Victoria, in BC, and then...
Emily?
Huh?
In two different locations?
Yeah, my grandfathers. They didn't know each other, of course. So one was in Victoria, BC, and one was in Toronto. And they both found Heaven and Hell in public libraries.
Wow.
Yeah, it's pretty interesting.
That's so weird.
It's his most common book, Heaven and Hell.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's his most popular book.
Do you know Jorge Luis Borges?
Yeah, he's in there in my listing.
Yeah, that's how I know about him.
Oh, okay, the Nobel Prize, yeah. He wrote a lot about Swedenborg, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I have a listing there of 9 pages of people that were influenced by Swedenborg, and of course he's there.
Do you have a favorite bunny movie?
No, but I do like Space Jam, because Lola was introduced as Bugs Bunny's girlfriend.
Yeah, and you're a panda first?
Well, I am, because she's the only girl bunny. If you think about it, there's Peter Rabbit and Brer Rabbit and Roger Rabbit, and they're all boy bunnies. She's the only famous girl bunny.
I didn't even think of that.
Yeah. True. People love to say, well,
Jessica Rabbit, I guess it's not
she's
really.
Human.
She's human.
See, she's human.
Yeah.
Yeah. But people love to say, what about Peter Rabbit's mother? I said, what's her name? Peter Rabbit's mother. You know, really.
Yeah, she's not a character.
No, she's not a famous.
Yeah.
She's a C-list.
She's a C-list.
Yeah. You're trying to think of all the famous bunnies.
Yeah,
I can see you.
The lady bunnies.
Yeah, yeah. No, there aren't. Rabbit from Winnie the Pooh, Thumper from Bambi. They're all boy bunnies. Brer Rabbit.
Bunny stuff from Hong Kong specifically.
All
is
this.
That why you have a section? Is they're just popular there?
Well, I went to Hong Kong and brought it all back, so that's all
wow.
Specifically Hong Kong.
I didn't know Balzac was too important.
Yes, he wrote quite a bit.
Yeah.
About.
Saul Bellow, isn't he Jewish?
Well, if you read his books, he writes about Swedenborg a lot.
Right.
So somebody can be born something and then have a different influence.
Mm.
but you read.
Well, these are people that are just like.
That wrote about Swedenborg.
Right. Okay.
Or if after their death, letters were found where they wrote back and forth to their mother or their son or somebody and said, oh, you got to read this. It was a great, interesting chapter or whatever.
What is Ingmar Bergman's connection?
He said that Swedenborg kept him out of insanity, that it kept him sane, and he realized that he was being influenced by evil spirits, and that really wasn't him, but kept him from being crazy.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah, it's pretty interesting stuff.
Do you have another favorite living museum in LA that you visited that you like?
That's a good question. No.
No.
The answer would be no. Gamble House is pretty good.
What is that one about?
The Gamble House is the old Procter & Gamble family, a lot of money, and all the house is made in the arts and craft movement, where there's no nails, it's all wood, everything is wood, it's really, really
the
beautiful.
Stuff?
Yes, where arts and that? Crafts. It's actually here in Pasadena. It's like 5 minutes from here. You can look it up, Gamble House. I must take a photograph of your bunny.
I've never seen
it. Isn't that fabulous?
Yeah, it does make it, like, pop out.
It literally elevates off the pavement. It's very cool.
Look at that color.
Bunnies have pink noses?
Well, go ahead and do it. They do, but they're covered with,
fur?
Yeah. Sometimes around their ears it's pink. So did you make yours 3D?
Wow.
Yeah, nobody believes me when I tell them it's really 3D. So did you fix yours and make it 3D?
I did make it 3D.
If you add extra colors, then it elevates when you do the opposite color.
That's so great. I have a migraine, but it's great.
I got a migraine.
You have a migraine?
Oh, look at that.
I didn't wear these for too long. I was like flirting. I was dancing on the razor's edge of one. Saying
that's
your,
cool.
Your name for me.
I'm Candace Frazee.
Great, thank you.
You're welcome.
Frazee,
as in frizzy hair. Frazee.
Oh, nice.
That's the easiest way to remember.
Where's Steve?
Frazee. He's at our bike shop. He owns a bicycle shop.
Oh, cool.
He's selling bicycles.
So you still got bunnies every day now?
Yeah, we give each other a gift every day as
you
a love token.
Today?
We haven't done it yet. The ones on the table are the newest ones. So it fills up, and then I inventory them, and then find a spot for them.
How do you find more bunnies? Do you go online and order 10 of them, 10 things at a time?
We have gone online, but no, we like bunny hunting. We prefer going to antique stores. Bunny hunting. We're vegetarians, so it's a double pun.
There, 3D.
Oh, that's fantastic. That's fantastic.
Better than this one.
Job.
I'm not done.
No, yours is good.
That was not good.
That's very good. It certainly is much brighter now than the green.
Oh, but that was just the base color. That was a shot of shit.
I'm going to put a halo on the piece
of glass. Oh, I like halos.
That's the best one you got.
Did you do one?
No, I didn't do one.
Heard that
job. How many people do you come every day?
Anywhere from 2 to 200. It just varies.
200?
Well, when you signed in, did you see the number? It's over 18,000.
Wow.
Yeah, so.
And will you tell it, since I think I might have missed it, what's the story about you and Steve and how you give each other a bunny?
We call each other Honey Bunny. So we give each other a bunny gift every day as a love token.
And that's how the museum started?
Yeah. Well, that's how the collection started. That's not how the museum, it's how the collection started.
What's the difference? Oh, the collection is the museum.
It's a private, it's a private thing between Steve and I.
Right.
You know, I didn't know you knew him. Now I do.
We were in a movie together.
No, you hit him. I thought you were with the other people.
I'm with everyone.
Are you with the other two people?
Yeah.
Those are his parents.
Those are and you're all... I thought you were three groups.
We're all together.
And then we just
she's my girlfriend.
That's my boyfriend.
Well, all this claiming. But see, I only really knew him because you hit him.
Yeah.
I thought he was a little fresh sitting on the same bench with you, but then you hit them, and then I knew for sure. What movie were you in?
We're in a movie called Safety Not Guaranteed.
Safety Not Guaranteed.
Coming out in June.
That's cute. That's cute.
It's about time travel.
Excellent.
There's no bunnies in it.
No. Excellent.
I don't think so. Do you celebrate Easter?
Yes.
What do you do?
We have an open house.
Oh, wow. Is it really busy? That's an, probably a really busy.
Yeah, a couple hundred. From 2 to 7. I think I hear the phone. Excuse me.
What should I get Candace tomorrow? I know I'll get her a bunny.
Hop on over.